Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Now, yesterday we had Pierre's question where I had to create this XY chart with five different series, and I had to create the chart with one series and then go through and add tediously series 2, series 3, series 4, series 5. You know, I'm saying to myself, there must be some way to tell Excel about all of these series at once. And my initial attempt at this was to set up a data set where I had the X and Y for series 1, and then the X and Y for series 2, the X and Y for series 3, the X and Y for series 4, and so on. But unfortunately, while any rational person would set up the data this way, that's not how Microsoft interprets it. What they did was they said, okay, well, this is the X for all of the series. This is the Y for series 1, Y for series 2, Y for series 3, Y for series 4, and I ended up with 9 series instead of the 5 that I wanted. So, we can fool Excel. And you'll have to decide for yourself if this is an easier way to go. I'm going to build a fake data set with the 5 series names that I want up here. And I'll use insert, scatter chart, bam, and then here's what we get to do. We're going to go through one by one and choose each series. Let's kind of arrange this so we can see the chart and see the data. And so we go to the layout tab, choose series 1, which is called series red, and we're going to grab the X and resize it down, and then grab the blue outline and point to the Y for series 1. Alright, so good, that's done. Now we can go on to series orange, and again they're going to redraw it back up. You see where they thought that first column was the X for all of them. We'll resize that down and then grab the blue and drag that down to the Y for series 2. And then up here, the next one, series green. Again, we're just going to keep repeating this process. I think it's a little bit easier to drag these boxes around and resize them than go through the add series and point to each series individually. At least this kind of gets them there. The names are there correctly. To me, it's a slightly easier way to go. And then once we complete this process, of course, we're still going to have to go through and use the exact same steps that we did yesterday in order to change the markers to circles and change the colors of the markers, but that's still the same process. That doesn't change at all. But I think that this method here, at least it gets the right number of series in. Probably if I was a little bit smarter, I would have made most of the series be exactly 3, or all of the series be exactly 3, because then I wouldn't have to resize here. So whichever one you have the most of is probably what we would go through and do. Now from this point, we're just going to repeat the same steps we did yesterday in order to change all of those markers to circles. Go back and watch yesterday's podcast rather than watch me go through that tedious bit again. So, you know, Pierre wrote in and said, I ended up creating this in PowerPoint because there didn't seem to be any way to do it in Excel. Well, there are a couple of ways to do it in Excel. Unfortunately, neither one of them is at all friendly or intuitive. However, it can be done. So there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.